Hello, sustainable growers. Welcome in this video. Today, I would like to respond to a question that I received from Amanda. She asked me, what is the specificity in aquaponics? What should we do exactly to grow some nice fruits? So when you start aquaponics in the first few months, I recommend to start with some leafy vegetables. So I'm talking about, for example, herbs such as mint, you can grow celery, you can grow some spinach, silver beets, lettuce, all those kind of veggies that are produced in leaves and not especially the fruit. And the reason why is because fruits need a lot of different nutrients to be able to develop the fruit. You know, it's a bit more complex than just building the leaves. So I recommend to wait for at least 6 months for the setup to cycle properly, to develop a nice biodiversity of different insects and different animals and also bacteria that are going to be able to break down all these organic matters in different particles, being able to release all the minerals from the fish food and being able to release and to offer a nice profile of nutrients to your plants and to your vegetables. So after 6 months, you got this biodiversity that is here. You know, you got all those insects that are here, and as soon as an organic matter falls in the system, as soon as you got some fish poo that is pumped up into the grow bed, those animals are here to break it down in different parts and to offer this wonderful range of nutrients to your plants. So then you can start to plant some fruits. So you can grow some tomatoes, you can grow some chili. I mean, the number of fruits you can grow in aquaponics is very wide. There are a lot of different plants that you can put in aquaponics that are gonna produce amazing fruit. When the fruit are growing, you know, the fruits, at the beginning they are flowers, right? That's how it works. You got a plant, you got some plants that are gonna produce some leaves and you're gonna be able to consume the leaves. And you got some plants, such as this lovely chili here, that are gonna produce some flowers. And those flowers are going to produce some fruits. So here, for example, we got one nice chili. You can see it's still green, but that's the idea. So you start with the plant is growing, and then it's going to develop some nice flowers, and the flowers are going to develop some nice fruits. So you see, it's a bit more complex. You are not just going to produce the leaves. You need to produce some leaves, and then you need to produce some flowers, and then some fruits. So to produce the flowers, the plant is going to need a lot of nutrients and especially potassium. So potassium or potash is something that you can find everywhere in all different food. There is some potash in all veggies, but the plants, when they go to flowers, they need a higher quantity of potash. So there is a source of potassium inside the fish food that you give to your fish. There is some potassium inside, and when you put it into the water, you got those bacteria that are going to break it down in small particles, and they're going to release the minerals, the potassium available for the plants. So the plants are going to be able to absorb this potassium, right? Now there is some interactions between the potassium, the calcium, and the magnesium. So they are not, you know, depending if you got a lot of calcium into your water, you're going to have less potassium available for the plant. What is very important to understand here is that if you add some potassium into the setup, yes, it's going to improve the general health of the vegetables, but reaching a certain point, it's going to help all the plants to go into flowers, into seeds, and into fruits, right? But even the plants that are growing some leaves normally, if you put a lot of potassium into your setup, they're going to start to produce some seeds. So that's where you have the lettuce, for example, that is going to grow in height and develop the flowers and the seeds. And that's what you don't want, basically. So there is this balance to find between having a setup that is going to produce some excellent fruit, but the leafy vegetables are going to grow quickly in seed, or trying to get your setup to produce some nice leaves and having a nice production of fruit, but not a crazy one. So there is this kind of choice that you need to make, right? That's why I like to add potassium in my setup. It's very important to have potassium, and naturally there is potassium already in the fish food, but if you want, you can add a bit more. But just be careful of not putting too much potassium, because then you're going to have obviously amazing fruits, but you're going to have also all the leafy vegetables that are going to grow seeds, and therefore they are not going to produce leaves anymore. You need to find a good balance, and unfortunately it's very hard to put the exact good quantity of potassium into your water. Very hard to determine the quantity. So what I recommend is to add a bit of potassium and to see how the system reacts. So the easiest way to add some potassium into your aquaponic setup is to add some potash. So you can buy some potash granular from your garden shop. You can buy some organic one. This one, for example, is potash and sulfate. Potassium is one of the very important elements, right, in the plant. So you got NPK. So the first N is for nitrogen. The second P is for phosphorus, and then the K is for potassium. Here, this one is 0041, which means that there is zero nitrogen, zero phosphorus, and 41% of potassium. So it's very, very high in potassium, and when you're going to add this into your water, you are not going to add any other fertilizer, which is really good because nitrate is already very high in aquaponics because we produce it thanks to the fish, so we don't need to add anything, any nitrate into our aquaponic setup. But if you want to give a boost to your plants, you can add this. It's potassium. It's quite good for the plant, quite good for the fruits. But again, if you put too much of it, you may have your lettuce that are going to grow into seeds very quickly. So use it very carefully, not too much, just a little bit. So I hope this video was useful. If you want to receive more videos of this type, subscribe to the channel. I will give you one aquaponics tip every week. Don't forget to get the free guide from the description of the video, which is a 6-step process to help you to build and manage your aquaponics setup in the best conditions. See you in the next video. Bye-bye. Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop!